Hello everyone, nice to see you again. Today we'll take up lesson 3. Please send me a card. 大家好，今天我们学习第三课，请给我寄张明信片吧。Please send me a card. Well, the story is about a man whose holiday in Italy was spoiled by postcards. 这篇课文讲的是有一个人去意大利度假，却因为明信片而没度好这个假。到底是怎么回事呢？ Well, you'll soon learn about it. But first, let's start with keywords and expressions. 首先呢，我们还是来看一看课文中的关键词和短语。Send a postcard. Spoil. Italy.它的形容词形式是 Italian, Museum, Public Garden, Land, Make a Decision, Single. Okay, now we'll move on to questions on the text. 下面呢，我们就进入到课文的问题的部分，请大家一起看一下。Where did the writer spend his holidays last summer? 去年夏天，作者是在什么地方度的假？ Why didn't he enjoy his holidays? 为什么他没度好那个假？ What did he do on the last day of his holidays? 假期的最后一天，他做了什么？
Postcards.Always spoil my holidays. Last summer, I went to Italy. I visited museums and sat in public gardens. A friendly waiter taught me a few words of Italian. Then he lent me a book. I read a few lines, but I did not understand a word. Every day, I thought about postcards.My holidays passed quickly, but I did not send cards to my friends. On the last day, I made a big decision. I got up early and bought 37 cards. I spent the whole day in my room, but I did not write a single card.
Well,Have you got the main idea of the story? 大家是否抓住了故事的大意呢? Let's check it out by following those questions. 那么下面我们就通过那些问题来了解一下故事的主要内容。The first question is, Where did the writer spend his holidays last summer? 作者去年夏天是在什么地方度的假?He spent his holidays in Italy last summer. 他呢是在意大利度的假。Why didn't he enjoy his holidays? 为什么他的那个假没有度好? Because he thought about postcards every day. 因为他每天都在想着明信片的事儿。What did he do on the last day of his holidays? 假期的最后一天，他做了什么呢？ Well, he made a big decision. 他做了一个很大的决定。He bought 37 cards and spent the whole day in his room. But he didn't write a single card. 他买了37张明信片，在屋子里待了一天。可是呢，却一张明信卡也没有写成。Right, that's it for the questions and answers. Now, let's look at the language points in the lesson. 好，问答我们就做到这儿。下面呢，我们来看看课文中的语言点。Postcards always spoil my holidays. 明信片总是使我的假期过得不得安宁。Spoil 这个词。意思是 把什么事情搞糟糕、搅乱。我们来看看例句。Don't spoil the pleasure. 别扫兴。You should not spoil your child. 你不应该惯孩子。Spoil 在这里的意思是浇灌、灌坏。I visited museums and sat in public gardens. 我参观了博物馆，也去观赏了一些公园。Public gardens 翻成中文可以说是公园，但是它和我们通常所说的公园 park 不完全一样。Park 比较大，而 gardens 一般的比较具有观赏价值，比如说有不同风格的 gardens， 有意大利式的花园 Italian garden， 有西班牙式的花园 Spanish garden。 所以呢Pub sat in public gardens， 意思是去那些花园观赏。那么既然有 public gardens， 自然也就有 private gardens， 意思就是私家花园。好，我们再看下一个原点。A friendly waiter taught me a few words of Italian。 一个友好的服务员教了我几句意大利语。 A few words of Italian意思是几句意大利文。好，下面呢，我们再看看这种说法的例句。I'd like to say a few words on the topic. 我想就这个话题再说几句话。这里的 say a few words 意思呢，也是说几句。再看下一句。Can I have a word with you? 我可以和你说句话吗？ Have a word with somebody 是一个习惯说法。意思是和谁讲句话，不能说 Can I have a few words with you? Then he lent me a book. 接着呢，他借给我一本书。Lend 意思是把什么东西借给某人。那么向谁借东西呢？要用 borrow。请大家注意，这和我们中文中同一个借字。用法不一样。请看例句。Can I borrow some money from you? 我可以管你借些钱吗？这里呢 borrow 是向谁借钱，和介词 from 搭配使用，向谁借东西。Some people neither borrow nor lend. 有些人既不向别人借钱也不借钱给别人。这里 borrow 是向谁借东西， lend 是借东西给别人。在这个例句中呢，这两个字都同时用到了。 On the last day I made a big decision. 最后一天呢，我做出了一个很大的决定。 Make a decision 做决定。做决定呢，还可以有其他几种说法，和其他的动词搭配使用。我们来看一下。Come to a decision. Arrive at a decision. Reach a decision. 我们再看下一个原点。I did not write a single card. 我连一张明信卡也没有写。Single 强调是单数的概念。 There wasn't a single person on the beach. 海滩上一个人也没有。 Now we'll move on to key structures and usage. 下面呢，我们就来讲一讲关键结构和用法。在这一节里，我们要讲的是一个动词带双宾语这样一个结构。下面我给大家挑出一些英语中常用的带双宾语的动词。这些动词有 lend, send, give, bring, get, make, leave, show。 好，下面呢，我们通过例句来看看这些动词的用法。He lent me a book. 他借给我一本书。在这里 ，me 和 book 都是 lend 这个动词的宾语。me 是直接宾语 ，book 是间接宾语。那么这句话也可以这么说 ：He lent a book to me。好，我们再看下一句。He sent me a card。他寄给我一张卡。同样，这句话也可以把它改成 He sent a card to me。原来的直接宾语呢，通过介词 to 来表现。Please give him another chance。请再给他一次机会。那么，把这个双宾语结构也可以改成下面这样一句子 ：Please give another chance to him. He brought his son a present. 他给儿子带回来一样礼物。换个说法呢，可以说 ：He brought a present for his son. Can you get me a few stamps? 你能替我买几张邮票吗？那么也可以说 ，Can you get a few stamps for me? She made me a breakfast. 她给我做了一份早餐。也可以说 ，She made a breakfast for me. His uncle left him some money. 他的叔叔给他留了一些钱。也可以说 ，His uncle left some money to him.She showed her friends her new dress. 她给她的朋友看了看她新买的衣服。这句话也可以说 ，She showed her new dress to her friends. 刚才我给大家介绍了英语中能够带双宾语的最常用的几个动词，请大家留意一下。一般的来讲，动词跟双宾语的结构在口语中用的比较多，因为它比较简洁。好，最后呢，我们再回到课文的故事内容上来。那么，故事中的主人公为什么会被明信卡搅得不得安宁呢 ？Why was he so much bothered by postcards？ 答案实际上是在故事的标题中，因为他出外旅游的时候，他在去意大利旅游的时候，他的朋友一定跟他说。Please send me a card， 给我寄几张风光明信片。那么这种情况也是很常见的，比如说你外出旅游的时候，你的朋友也会让你寄一些卡片，或者呢买一些礼物 souvenir。但是呢，这样的话给外出旅游的这些人呢，就会带来很多的负担，因为并不是每一个人在外出旅游的时候都有心思写卡片，或者呢到处去转去买礼物。所以呢 ，my advice is relax and enjoy。我的建议就是，外出玩的时候就要放松，就要玩得愉快。Okay, that's it for today's session. Until next time, goodbye.